your global distribution via wholesale buyers. Hey guys, it's Shama. I know most of you guys are super eager and excited about going global, selling into bigger markets. I was just talking to a client the other day about new opportunities to sell in India, new opportunities to sell in China, and certainly also penetrating into the European and looking to the Japanese markets, etc. There's so much incredible opportunity, especially right now looking at markets, that I really want to talk to you about how to go about this process in a really systematic way. Now, when you think about approaching a global market, first, we've got to make sure that we identify what are the key markets and make sure that you're building and growing your brand to suit that market. Remember, it's not just as easy as flipping on a switch online and saying, hey guys, boop, international shipping. No, a little bit more than that. The next thing is identifying who those wholesale buyers are, building those relationships. And then lastly, it's going to be to identify and take a look at international showrooms. Looking at finding sales reps, international showrooms can be an amazing way of being able to dive into traditional markets that you may not otherwise have been able to get into. All right, let's dive in. So you first have to identify exactly what market you want to get into. Now, why is that important? Well, certainly if you're interested in breaking into the Middle Eastern market, which guys, another big hotspot, you want to make sure that you have the right assortment, right? You want to make sure that maybe you have some more modest clothing that is still very directional and very fashion forward. Recently, we were doing an open to buy for one of our clients in Bahrain, and we went to Paris Fashion Week, we went to New York Fashion Week. We met with so many amazing designers and brands that were actually creating pieces that were catered specifically to the Middle Eastern market. Now, this is very important because different markets have different climates and are looking for different kinds of products during the same traditional buying seasons. So having a global mindset is likely to also impact and influence your traditional merchandising and assortment planning. Now next, we've got to make sure that you're talking to the right buyers. Certainly exchanging emails and communicating, you know, over the phone, etc., can be a great way of starting to get initial soft outreaches and being able to gauge interest. However, we all realize the importance of face-to-face communication and really making sure that someone gets to see and touch, feel and experience your brand. So it's very important to think about either traveling to your specific target market or starting to take a look at showrooms that will give you international exposure. These days, guys, we've been seeing a lot of the LA markets and showrooms really getting kind of a more national clientele, meaning people are coming in from the Midwest, from even some smaller doors in New York, people who are trying to really cater to that lifestyle. We're also seeing a lot of retail owners coming in from Japan and parts of Asia coming into Los Angeles for those markets. We're also, in a flip side of that, over at the Paris Fashion Week, we're seeing a lot more European designers and Middle Eastern brands that are starting to come and really showcase and get visibility in the Paris Market Weeks, either during showroom appointments or during fashion shows, etc. So when it comes to picking your spots and figuring out where you want to do a trade show, ask yourself, what are the particular buyers that I really want to be focusing and targeting on? Certainly Magic, when we look at Women's Wear Daily Magic that happens in Vegas twice a year. Again, you see a global market, but you don't see so many of the European buyers or so many of the Middle Eastern buyers. They're really focusing on New York market as well as Paris market. And from what I've been hearing, guys, is that Milan is going to be seeing a great resurgence in terms of bigger visibility, more trade shows, and I'm really eager to see what kinds of buyers end up showing up for that. Now, lastly, it's really important you guys consider working with an international showroom. Showrooms like Rainbow Wave have done an amazing job of really penetrating and tapping really deeply into those clientele and into that client base, that sometimes it might even be too much for you to just go and have a trade show twice a year and expect to really have that grounding and that foundation into being able to send samples whenever you need to, into being able to capture those buyers when they're traveling into your market, whenever they are, let's say, looking at other appointments, coming there for other business meetings, etc. So really consider using an international showroom. Now, what's great is that an international showroom can play in really nicely with your local showroom. So if you have a showroom that's based in the US, and let's say they're not strong in international markets, or maybe they don't even do international, you can complement that with a really strong international showroom presence. The combination of those forces will not only drive sales locally in your domestic market, but really start to move the needle on getting you exposure into the Middle East, into the Asian markets, European markets. And guys, please don't discount the rising upper middle class and the rise of the luxury consumer in China and India. Oftentimes we're thinking about places like, oh, I want to be sold in Japan, I want to open up doors in Tokyo, because we already know about the GDP and how strong the economy is. But looking into markets like China and India are amazing opportunities for you to start to penetrate where there isn't so much competition right now. So remember, yes, everyone wants to be in the US. A lot of people see the big bucks and the dollars here. However, guys, growing markets are really an amazing place to start to think about when it comes to growing wholesale business models. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. Super excited to see what markets you end up launching into. Leave us comments below. Head on over to our Instagram channel to be able to check out more tips and tricks. And when you guys are ready to put together a cohesive sales strategy that's going to allow for global domination, please shoot us an email at hello@scalingretail.com. And guys, to get more information about what to do around things like going global, around things like growing your business models, please hit our download called Going Global. It is an amazing ebook. It'll go over lots of different strategies, both for your e-com as well as your wholesale. And make sure you check out our blog post on which trade shows are the best ones to attract that global audience that you're looking for. I think this is an amazing blog post. It really goes in depth so you can start to make the best decisions for your first international footprint. Talk to you soon. Have a great day. Bye.